Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. In today's video guys, we'll be working on a BMW here at the shop guys. And we're going to share information how to fix a code 9388 belt tensioner. That's a very common code on BMW guys. Any BMW, we're working on a 3 series now, but the code will relate to any BMW. And it will be specific code for one certain part, okay, for the passenger side belt tensioner. We'll discuss what could cause that, how to fix it, and you can find the information and the video on our channel how to test it. So what we'll be doing now, okay, we'll go ahead and connect the scanner quick. Okay, I'm going to show you here and we're going to read the codes. But before that, okay, let me start the car and show you airbag light is on. Okay, you see airbag light stays on all the time. So now what we're going to do, okay, we'll use the Maxicomi here, nothing sponsored, this is a product that we use. Okay, check out all the cars you can do with that thing, it's amazing guys. If you're looking for a good scanner, check this thing out, I'll definitely recommend it. We'll go to wind detection so it can detect the vehicle and model that we have here. It's going to decode everything. Okay, it will take just about probably 10-15 seconds. Then you have to confirm that this is the correct VIN number. Okay, and we're going to wait for the program to load now. So it will be any minute now, it's loading the data. Sometimes it takes a little bit longer depending how complicated your vehicle is. We're going to go to diagnostics, control unit, the airbag system is part of the body system. Drive is, you have the transmission and the engine, chassis, all the ABS, traction control. So we need to go under body system, airbag module here, and we're going to read the codes and check out what the first code now is. 9388, okay, right there. This is seatbelt tensioner passenger side. Now this code guys relates to the, okay, to the seatbelt buckle here. This is on the, we're on the passenger side now, any BMW will be that way. This is your seatbelt buckle. Now we have one sensor that detects if the belt is installed, but this will trigger a different code. We'll have the video. The tensioner itself is on the bottom side under the seat. It's about that long. It's part of the seatbelt buckle. You can check out on the channel how to test the seatbelt buckle. We have it and what it looks like. It's super simple to test and it tells you if yours is good or bad. It'll probably take you less than a minute to test it. Another thing is, you don't even have to remove the seat in most cases to test your seatbelt buckle. And we'll show you how you can do that. The recommended thing is to remove the seat so you can make sure you're getting the correct signal, the correct wires. Let me demonstrate quick. So now I'll go under the passenger seat here and you can see this is the connector right there. Okay, and that connector I already disconnected it. Okay, in our case you can check those wires, okay, right here. This is your tensioner, okay, on the side. You can see it under the seat. It's that long tube that's part of the seat belt buckle. And there is two wires coming from it, from the tensioner and from the seat belt buckle. Two double wires. And they go to, in our case, to the middle connector. Okay, in your case, you have to see which connector is yours. And now we have, right there, okay, we have four wires. Two are for the seat belt buckle. If you put your seat belt, it tells you if you did it or not. And the two other ones are for the seat belt tensioner. In some cases they will differ, they will be like double pins. That's where you can test yours and see if it's good. But in some cases guys, it could be just a bad connection here, okay? So make sure that you clean everything really good. Ours had spilled coffee. So clean really good, make sure all the pins are straight and they go in those little holes right here. And after that, okay, just go ahead and install it. And if your tensioner is good, that code will go away. So hopefully the video will be helpful to some of you guys. Please hit that subscribe button. Many more videos to come and see you guys next time.